everybody, I'm Katie, welcome to the Book Buddies, and you're back where you're supposed to be! Yes! I'm so excited, I realized that I have a short little tub, and my typewriter box, and some other things that I could stack to have you up there. I don't know why I didn't realize that sooner, but I didn't. So, anyway, you're where you're supposed to be, and today's video is going to be the coffee book tag, and I've got coffee here in my adorable Totoro mug, which is one of my favorite animated films of all time. So, let's get started. I thought about doing the slurpy sound, but it's kind of hard to drink when you do that. Okay, so I didn't really think about the answers to these questions beforehand, and I'm not sure who created the tag originally, but I'll leave the two videos that I watched down below, and then if I find the original, I'll put that one down there too, along with the questions and all that stuff. I don't know why I'm out of breath. I've been talking too much, that's why. Anyway, on to the tag. The first question thing, or type of coffee, I guess, is black, which I can actually drink. Name a series that's hard to get into, but has hardcore fans. I'm just gonna hold up the... no. Game of Thrones, the Song of Ice and Fire series. It is really hard to read. It takes forever to get anywhere in it, and I'm only like 100-something pages in, and I mean, it's good. It is good. I can see why people like it, but it's so hard to read. And it makes it like hard to get into, you know what I mean? Because it's like, I've been reading for an hour and I've gone through 5 pages. Okay then, just keep on going. Like, that's what it's like. And I like it so far, so there's that at least. Coffee number 2 is peppermint mocha. I've never had that before. Name a book that gets more popular during the winter or festive time of year. Oh, I know a good one for this. Put that back up there. I don't know why that... okay. Be loud and crash. Okay. I probably shouldn't have put these up here like this. Ah, go back. No. Don't fall. Okay. Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Really mystery novels in general, but Sherlock Holmes just seems like a good wintry. I don't know. If Sherlock Holmes specifically gets more, is read more during the winter or not, but I know that a lot of people like to read detective stuff and mysteries during the winter, so just pulled out this one, because this is the most detective-y book that I have, although I do have mysteries, but still, I don't really own Christmas books. Should probably fix that. Not even gonna put that up because difficultness. Okay. Hot chocolate. What's your favorite children's book? Don't even have to think about this. Okay, I know a lot of people don't think that this is a children's book, but it was technically written in the 1930s for children, so it counts. And yes. It's kind of sad that children in the 1930s could read this, and most college kids nowadays can't. But, you know, things change. Took me forever to read, like 2 years. Anyway, put this back up. on coffee. Anyway, what was the next one? Ah, double shot of espresso. That's not that much espresso. Name a book that kept you on edge from start to finish. This is a good one. Ooh, this one. Okay. The Ghost in the Takedo Inn by Dorothy and Thomas Hubler. This is a mystery novel. Just a minute. Just a minute! Stop! What the heck? Okay. sorry. this I bought in Idaho like 3 or 4 years ago, and I read it on the way home, and it was really good. It was like, it had a creepy story in it, and I don't know, it just made me keep wanting to read. It was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I don't really know how to tell you what it's about. It's about a boy who wants to be a samurai, but you can't be a samurai if you're not born into a samurai family. That kind of thing. And then there's a jewel that's stolen while he's at an inn, and then they have to try to find this jewel, but he's saying that it was a demon because that's what it looked like. And yeah, anyway, it was just a really good story. I don't know. It's very nostalgic. I bought it at a used bookstore. So I'm okay with it being all messed up because I think it adds character. Next one, I think. Yes. The next one is Starbucks. Name a book you see everywhere. I'm just going to pull this one out. The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. Pretty sure you know what this is about, but you see it everywhere. If people haven't read it, they probably own it. I'm pretty sure everybody on BookTube at least owns a copy. It's a good book, though, so I can see why everybody has read it and loves it. Yes. I should probably put that up, actually. Do-do-do-do. It's a weird angle. Flaw. Just kidding. That was weird. Okay, that hipster coffee shop. Give a book by an indie author a shout-out. Do I own any indie authors? I think I do. Pretty sure I have one. Oh, here it is. I think. I don't know. It doesn't say, but I think it's an indie author. It doesn't have, like, a, Tate Publishing. I don't know, but Rhonda Russell. I never read this, actually. I got it signed, though, you know, so I didn't mean to buy this. Kind of bought it by accident. But anyway, so I don't know if that's technically an indie, because there is a publishing company, but that's like the closest thing I have to an indie author. I don't really pay much attention to what's an indie author and not, so yeah. Next one. Oops, you accidentally got decaf. How can you even tell if you've gotten decaf or not? I mean, it tastes exactly the same as regular, unless it's like a high-end brand. I don't know. A book you were expecting more from. What is a good one? The problems of not thinking about this beforehand. I guess I'll go with Gone Girl. I really don't like this book. I did a rant on it and everything, but I still have it because Kayleen gave it to me, and because it's a book added to my collection, and I don't care if I don't like the book or will never ever read the book. I'm never getting rid of it, unless it's a certain Unless it's like, I think I've gotten rid of 3 books ever. And I just gave them to my sister. But anyway, yeah. I was expecting this to be really, really good because, like, everybody that I had seen on BookTube really liked it. And people that I have similar interest in books with liked it. But reading it, it wasn't suspenseful at all. I didn't really care what happened by the end of it. So this one's one that I was definitely expecting more from because I really, really wanted to read it. And I was so excited when Kaylin got it for me, and I'm still... But, yeah. I don't know what else to say. I won't bother leaving the rant down there because you probably don't want to hear me babbling on and on about how much I hated it, but because that would be rude, but I... Anyway. The Perfect Blend. Name a book or series that was bittersweet but ultimately satisfying. This one. Wonder by R.J. Palacio was the saddest, or the most, oh, I don't even know. It was so cute. It was so adorable. It was such a cute story, but it was so sad at the same time, and by the end of it, you were just like, ugh. It was so satisfying, the ending. I loved this book. This was, I think, in my top 5 favorite books of last year. I loved this book. It was so good. It was so good. And if you haven't read it, I recommend everybody read this. Everyone. This is the only, not the only contemporary, but one of the only contemporaries that I've just really, really adored. So yes. Yes. You need to get it. You need to read it. And it's super short. It's a kid's book. So it's middle grade. So it's really fast to read. I could have read it in a day, but I had a really bad headache, and reading was not helping the headache, so I had to put it down. But I only had, like, 12 pages left. Anyway. So that, guys, was the coffee book tag. I hope you enjoyed it. If you wish to do this tag, go right ahead. I tag you, and I also tag Kayleen to do this because I know she's a coffee lover. And... rate, comment, can you even rate stuff? Why do people say rate? I don't even know. Like, comment, and subscribe if you so wish to see our videos in the future. My Weekly Geeks, let's face it, I just was bad at Weekly Geeks. But during the summer I will have more of a schedule, and that way I hope that I will be able to actually put them up weekly. And I'm going to do my best to actually do that. So yes, Weekly Geeks will be back up during the summer. And until next week, I need a book. We'll do this one. Goodbye. This is the wrong page, but it's not like I'm actually reading it anyway. Oh, I didn't turn you off.